Bonjour, William.
Bonjour, Hanan.
Good morning, Hanan.
Good morning.
Good morning, Jerry.
How are you?
I'm fine. And you?
I can see you're fine. You're in a very business mood this morning.
Yeah, for sure.
Très beau costume.
Merci.
Ça vous va très bien.
Merci à Africa News.
Alors cette semaine, William.
So this week in the business segment, you were talking to us about the conditions for a return to economic prosperity in Zimbabwe.
And that is so, Hanan. Here in your program a few days ago, you spoke on the Army announcement on the end of operation intended to restore legality. The operation, you remember, dropped Robert Mugabe. And the idea is to highlight the fact that the army is not currently in charge in Zimbabwe. However, the international community remains skeptical on the new leadership in Harare, which has promised to revive the economy of the country. About a week ago, the new president of Zimbabwe, Emmerson Mnangagwa, called for the lifting of sanctions by the Western community, which had weighed down on Zimbabwe for more than a decade. This has been a challenge to Robert Mugabe since the last 15 years. The old leader has always claimed that the economy and financial crisis affecting the country is due to the economic sanctions that have been imposed upon it by the West. And when I spoke of Westerners, I am referring to United States, Great Britain, Australia, Canada.
And I also want to know, I mean, some of the nature of these sanctions Zimbabwe is facing.
Obviously, Jerry, I would like you to note that briefly that in international relations, a sanction is a set of coercive measures taken in general by the Western state to compel a third state to modify its policy direction. And for Zimbabwe, the Western nations that we talked about earlier have taken measures targeted against some individuals, but also a more global measures specifically aimed to isolate Zimbabwe. The most aspect of this sanction is the Zimbabwe Democracy and Economic Recovery Act, the ZEDERA, a law enacted in 2001 by the American government and intended ironically to restore democracy and economic stability in Zimbabwe. The general idea of this test is that the American representative must vote against any measures to assign loans or extensions of guaranteed or a cancellation of the debt of Zimbabwe and international financial institutions where the United States have a direct or indirect influence. It is the case of the World Bank, the International Monetary Fund, or even the African Development Bank. You may recall that in 2016, Zimbabwe was able to repay all its debt to the IMF. In spite of this, the country had not always had a right to borrow money because it could have to repay its advance all its creditors. And although they are presented as political sanctions intended to restore the rule of law, the Zimbabwe authorities have always consider the ZEDERA and all other Western sanctions as measures of retaliation for the land reform in the beginning of the year 2000. Reform designed to give the blacks majority access to land and therefore the production of wealth of the country.
Emmerson Mnangagwa demande la levée de ses fonctions. À quelles conditions, William, cette levée peut-elle restaurer la prospérité au Zimbabwe?
Oui, justement, la question de la levée des sanctions est une question difficile sur laquelle je me garderai bien de répondre.
It is a difficult question to answer, and that is what poses problems to Western capitals who ask the alternation. Alternating head as the best way to do away from Mugabe, and it was thought to get a rid of ideology of ZANU-PF. Only this reading is not necessarily the best way we have been able to see since. Zimbabwe is not strictly an autocracy, which Robert Mugabe could be the central figure. It is a patriotic understood as political system called by a political party that has the omnipresent and omnipotent, and in example, the ZANU-PF. And it is this that has the false hand of Robert Mugabe, once considered as pro-Western. And these political considerations have recessed economic consequences because, once again, Zimbabweans are armed and seem to win the battle for an opinion, United States, the European Union, and other countries justify.
L'absence d'alternance et de considération pour les opinions des citoyens, le nouveau pouvoir peut brandir les événements de novembre dernier et dire, tenez, nous avons fait ce que vous souhaitiez, mais est-ce que Emmerson Mnangagwa est vraiment ce que souhaitaient les autorités occidentales? Je ne suis pas sûr de cela. C'était la chronique business. Vous pouvez la retrouver ainsi que les dernières informations sur l'économie globale et l'économie africaine précisément sur notre site web africanews.com. Je suis William Baïha.